at the speed of light, like a bullet. I could be there by the morning. I can't call it, so I ain't got no time to wait. Wait. I've been down and out for too long, and I ain't got too many.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the start of the Iceland vlog. I was actually in Iceland literally a week ago with Josh, who is my detox coach. You guys probably have seen our little collaboration before this video, but I fell in love with Iceland so much that this time I'm doing a little company trip out there. So right now I'm actually sat in the lounge with Kieran, just having some food before we board the flight. Danny is picking up some shoes from the airport because he only brought one pair from Colombia. So Danny is actually here in London for a week. We have a Meridian Mastermind coming up on Friday, Saturday. So Monday to Thursday, I thought I would treat the team and take them to Iceland. So we're doing a little company trip to Iceland. So
I'm not allowed to drink. Right. I have to be sober for the flight, which is unfair.
Yeah, Kieran was like, we walked in and they have a really, really nice bar at the lounge here. And Kieran went straight, I saw his eyes lock into the bar, and I'm like, it is literally 12 o'clock on a Monday. There's no chance in hell you're going to get what were you even going to get?
A
nice wine or a whiskey. Well, okay. So definitely not happening on this company trip. This is meant to be a detox trip. Well, anyways, yeah, most of you guys were a little disappointed that I didn't vlog last trip. And just in general, I really haven't been vlogging. I haven't really released a vlog in maybe 9 months or something like that. Or actually, no, when I was uploading a couple times a week in Bali, but that's when I had Nabil. So yeah, first vlog in a while. Let's get into it.
Good flight, Danny?
Good flight.
What about you, Kieran?
I'm exhausted.
It's only like 3 hours. Exhausted from what?
Economy.
Did I hear that correctly?
Are we flying? We're better than that.
This is literally just our ploy to make sure that we fly business next time.
Well, you know how they normally do it? When it's like when it's normally like the CEO and founder, he sits in business and the...
But we do things differently.
We do things differently at our company. So, we just went ahead and grabbed all our bags. Kieran is actually off at the car rental place, picking up the car. I'm gonna bring it back round. So yeah, just finished up the flight. What I'm gonna attempt to do in this vlog is talk a little bit about leadership, company culture. Although I have a small team, you know, full time it's Danny, me, well, it's me, Danny, and Kieran, and then I also have Esteban, who works pretty much half time, part time, and then I've got people like Billy, who's obviously my full time health coach. I've got service providers and stuff like that. But if we look at, you know, like actual full time people, it's really just Danny, Kieran, and myself as part of the full-time company. And that is for the education company and the agency. So, as I said, what I'm going to try to do is really just talk a little bit about culture. I mean, the thing is, this trip is for me to shoot some marketing material for some upcoming projects, but it's also to build, you know, more company culture. We have such a lean, efficient, and just incredible team, and you're gonna see us joking around a lot because we have a funny dynamic. You know, we have an Englishman. I'm Russian, although, you know, I feel as though in demeanor I act half European, half American. We have a Colombian. It's a very like eclectic mix. So yeah, you know, we joke around a fuck ton, but at the end of the day, you know, I have such an amazing team, which is why both the agency and the education company are able to just really lead the way and lead the path, and really just do things that I haven't seen any other education company or any other agency, or accomplish things that I haven't seen any other education company or agency manage to accomplish. So one principle that you can learn immediately off the bat is, obviously, and this is just a small thing, you know, I sat in economy with the rest of the team. I was thinking of flying business with the entire team. But then I thought, you know, for the 750 we save on one leg of the journey, you know, that could be money spent towards some nice dinners, some experiences, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, in normal scenarios, really the founder or the CEO of a company will be sitting in business. And, you know, the employees will be sitting in the back. And to be honest, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I understand that. But to me, you know, especially because I have such a small team, I can't have any sort of hierarchy. And that's one principle you can take away. The second principle is, and Kieran even said this, I was sat here, Danny was sat here, Kieran was sat here. And, you know, Danny was playing like this snooker game on his phone. Rightly so, you know, it was a 3-hour long flight. You know, you can't always be switched on. Danny just came from a super long flight from Colombia, so the guy's, you know, poor guy is probably so tired. So Danny and Kieran were chatting, playing some games, etc., etc. And Danny was like, "Iman, play," and I was like, no, dude, like I'm reading, and I was doing a bit of journaling, just going through some problems in my head, some social and business problems that I was trying to deconstruct. And I was like, no, dude, I'm journaling, and then I'm like continuing and read. And Kieran goes, "Well, that's why he's the one paying for both our flights and our trip." And that is sort of the first principle that, you know, I've really learned is you really cannot have any sort of hierarchy. You know, my teammates, they question me all the time. And as I said, I'm really not a fan of having any hierarchy at all. That's number one. Number two is really just lead by example. You know, if I was on my phone watching movies, doing random bullshit on the flight, then, you know, how the hell is my team meant to respect me and see me as a leader? So that's the second principle. And I'm gonna share a few more along the rest of the vlog. And now Danny boy's back, gonna hop in the car rental and head into Reykjavik. As I said, I was literally here like a week ago, so gonna head to one of my favorite restaurants there from last time. So this is the whip for a few days. I wanted to get a G-Wagon, like a nice G63 or potentially a Range Rover SVR, but legitimately Kieran scoured all of Iceland and a Land Rover Discovery.
Poverty's back.
Land Rover Discovery was or Discoverer was the best that we could do. Funnily enough, I was here last week in a 2008 Grand Jeep Grand Cherokee, and that was the best possible option from the rental place that we went to. So this is still a big step up, you know. But I think I would have felt bad in like a G-Wagon. Like
this country's so modest. Like this. It's very
no, but like you, like here, this is like a big flex. Cause yeah, it is. It's not even that people don't have money. It's just it's a very modest place.
But like we'll turn it to the Reykjavik nightclubs and they'll know we've arrived.
Okay, so 9 Reese's cups for £1.20, and that used to be my lunch half the time. That and I don't know if you remember, but at Sainsbury's, what you could do is you could take their. You used to have to like input the price of something with certain things. So I mean, as horrible as it sounds, it's probably produced some really bad karma for me. But like, I used to take like the pastries and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Just type in £1 when they weren't looking, and there we go. That was my lunch when I couldn't afford a real lunch. All right, we are here. Look at that. You guys, all right? What? Alright, so apparently there's a little lock box on the side here. Code, pull up Airbnb. Keys sorted. I've got 3 of my coats here, 2 Canada Goose, 1 Montclair. I think this may be the first Colombian I've ever seen wearing a coat like that.
In Iceland.
In first Colombian ever in Iceland, Danny. How do you feel?
I'm feeling great.
All right, so you guys are seeing this tour literally same time as me. This is the place. This is, honestly, this place is super cool. It's not as, let's see what's in here. It's not as big, okay. Apparently we're not meant to go in there. It's not as big as the place I was at last time, but this place is very, very cool.
Boom. All right. That is pretty much it. There is a really cool, there's a hot tub out there. Boom. Look at that. This is the view from the Airbnb. Wow. This is honestly
something else.
You look absolutely splendid, Danny.
Splendid. I like that word.
Splendid. What are you doing when you get back to Colombia?
I'm gonna do a 3-day fast.
3-day fast.
Yeah. Eat a little keto before.
Yeah?
Yeah, no carbs. Carbs are poison.
Is the French music still playing?
I don't know, I've got it on my phone.
Ah, okay. So, as I think most of you guys know, Billy, who's my full-time health coach, Billy also works with my team on their sleep, which is very entertaining because I know their Oura Ring stats, which I actually don't know. Guys, is that an invasion of privacy?
Yeah, it's a massive invasion of privacy.
Yeah. Yeah, I know exactly what time they go to bed and what time they wake up. But, yeah, so they work with Billy. And obviously, you guys remember or should remember Josh, Detox Dudes, from, you know, our time in Iceland together. Josh is now also working with Danny and then also working with Kieran. So I guess that's actually
some carbon.
Yeah, exactly. Charcoal. Some charcoal. So I guess that's actually principle number three, which is the fact that when you have A players, which I'm very, very lucky to have, even though I'll never actually tell them because I don't want them to get big headed. But, you know, when you've got some A players, when you've got, and it's taken me years to assemble a small but incredible team that I do have, when you find people like that, not only in terms of good pay, but just in terms of experiences like this. And I know with my team, health means a lot. And for me to, I know with my team, health means a lot. And if my team can perform at a high level, I don't care what it costs me. I don't care what it costs me. I don't care how much effort I have to put into it. Because if they're performing at a high level, they're going to be happier. And, from a selfish perspective, obviously, I'm going to get more out of them. Daddy's laughing. But, it's cool to see that my team's into biohacking. Danny is, like, full-blown into biohacking, detoxing, stuff like that. Kieran.
Cutting back on Diet Coke.
Kieran's cutting back on Diet Coke and whiskey. But he's definitely making progress. He's getting there.
Smell like that eggy smell is a sulfur.
Shoot.
That's what it's gonna be like at the geothermal spring tomorrow.
So is that actually hot? Really hot or what?
Yeah, it's quite warm.
Danny, dip your toe in. Dip your hand in, I dare you.
Go on, Danny.
A triple dip. This is what we're going in tomorrow. It's not like it's a...
You've been dead, Danny. You've got to do it now.
Look at that. Probably my hand will burn now.
We have a media buyer with only four fingers.
Oh, shit. I need that hand for that.
You okay? Didn't die?
Yeah. Didn't die.
I don't want to mess with it. The golden hand.
The golden hand.
Table and I'll trace it. Sorry.
Hey, G Media. Come on, buddy. Stick it on there.
So, table with me?
Yes, please. Yes.
Oh, man. There we go. Mm.
All right, do a little taste test, Danny. Try that. That is fresh salmon. Not like what you get in Colombia. Okay, I know that was a bullshit response because that was way too quick. Here, try it.
It's like eating a sweet.
It's what?
It's like eating a sweet.
A sweet?
It's so nice. That's that's an authentic response, by the way, Danny.
It like melts of the...
All right, so it is first morning here in Iceland. It is actually 8:05. I'm 5 minutes late for a call, but I just have a call with a service provider for the education company. Had my cold shower, went through my morning routine. So have this call, that'll be like 15, 20 minutes. And then after that, me and the team are gonna sit down, look over some client campaigns for the agency. And then I think this morning we need to shoot some ads and then we can get into the fun day-to-day stuff for today. First things first that I wanna do, it opens at 11, is go to the geothermal spring with a steam room sauna, cold lake, etc., etc. That's the first thing I wanna do, but we have 3 hours until it opens, so time to get some work done and then we can enjoy the rest of the day.
Again, search for the live room conversion, click on it, and then you can see it gets added into your panel, so you can then see it on the whole view. And 102 leads, so it's like a 20% conversion rate from your webinar landing page to the leads page, and then you can start breaking up your funnel and see your conversion rates. So yeah, questions, just message me on Slack. Done.
Yeah, what do you wrap up?
Just tell them for one of our clients so they can see their conversions better.
Awesome.
So ladies and gents, I wrapped up that call with that service provider. We have to, how many clients are we setting up some new ads for today?
Three.
So there's three clients we're launching quite a few new ad sets for. And yeah, any of you guys who run marketing agencies, Danny, how much has Loom saved your life when it comes to like explaining things to client? Because I mean, even that client just wanted to know about what tracking.
Yeah, so no, Loom is just one of the best tools you can ever use.
It condenses
so much information, and the actual fact that you share your screen, like, it just makes everything so much easier.
Yeah, I mean, for Danny literally to type that out, to type out that, you know, 2-3 minute video on tracking and attribution would have taken 15-20 minutes. Might have had to make some little screenshots and stuff like that. Instead, he can pull up Loom, chat for 2-3 minutes, and press end. The link is immediately ready, and it's off to the client. So yeah, if you aren't, get on Loom and start using it for your communication. It'll speed things up a hell of a lot if you're running a marketing agency, or actually if you're running any sort of service-based business, to be honest. So what happened?
This is half of my day.
Half of your day is just, okay, let me, have you removed the, okay.
Yeah, it's just.
You see, Danny, how many leads did we get for how much?
We've gotten 760 leads at £3.50 each, which is pretty great also.
759 leads at £3.55 in just, this client is just UK market.
And now we are down because Facebook doesn't like us at all.
Well, Facebook doesn't like anyone, to be honest. That's one of the unfortunate aspects of advertising with Facebook. We run ads to 70-80% of our clients are in the info product space. And that can be very, very tricky at times. So this is pretty routine. I'm just having a client's ads just get absolutely slammed, especially when it was doing so well. On cold, we were what, 2x?
A little bit more, yeah.
A little bit more, I think 2.5x on cold. And then obviously that was feeding the retargeting audience. So like ad total, like ad account total, I think we're at 3.5x. So yeah, shame, but comes with advertising on Facebook, unfortunately. So Chef Kieran has just gone ahead and prepared a little breakfast for us. Thank you, Kieran. And yeah, now we are about to play, Danny and I are about to play a little game of chess. I literally got Kieran to bring this over from London. He had to, what time do you go to Argos?
I was at Argos 8:30 in the morning.
So he was at this little like store at like 8:30 in the morning because he tried to deliver via Amazon, didn't come in time. But we've got the chess board, so about to play some chess, eat some breakfast, and then head off.
Can you cover that? Because there's some sensitive information there. But I'd love to record a video testimonial, dude. Just hit 56K this month and a mix of retainers and consulting work. One of the annoying things is I literally will get a fucking text message. I'll get a Facebook Messenger. I'll get Instagram DMs. I'll get messages all of the time from people and students hitting 10K a month, 20K a month, 50K a month, signing a 30K a month. Last week we had a 30,000 euro a month retainer that a student signed. So I get all these testimonials, but sometimes the little frustrating thing is people forget to post it in the Facebook community, or they forget to apply for their whale statues. I have this whale award that literally costs $200. So once you make six figures, once you join the six-figure club, which is making a six-figure year income, which in order to do that, you have to make 8,300, you know, monthly. So once people hit their first 8,000-9,000 a month from agency retainers, then they get their little Wilbert the Whale award statue. So it's incredible to see, because I literally will get one to two of these a day. But yeah, it's annoying that people forget to fill out their form sometimes. Because once they have that form, they get a bunch of, it's kind of like, you know, it's kind of like having like a, you know, a Platinum American Express or a Centurion American Express. It's just like, yeah, once you have it, you have like all these hosts of like rewards and like free shit. So yes, for those of you guys who are in the Grow Your Agency community, you know, in one of our programs, look, if you have hit a 8 to 10K month with your agency, then message Kieran, go into the Facebook community, message Kieran, ask for the form, and you will get a very, I mean, it's extremely bespoke and very beautiful looking. You'll get your own custom award, and you'll also get a whole host of other benefits for being in the six-figure club. So go do it.
How does the music work in this car?
What do you mean, how does it work?
Bluetooth. If I want to put my music, what do I need to do?
You take a music request.
On a type form?
You input it on type form, and then
you get a notification.
Send me a DM on Instagram, Danny. I will send you the type form.
And there we go.
Support at growyouragency.com. Music request for the car.
Is the music request? Yes, correct.
The systems guy.
The systems.
Still happy while wearing suit pants.
Yeah.
And white shoes. To ice.
Danny, the worst traveler in the world.
You get the award for the worst traveler on earth.
Thank you.
How do you do B-roll?
You always just.
How do you do B-roll?
I won't let him get the best of me. Magical flying gun, being in, I got a sign on, beat me up, I'm about to sign off, them or not, need to take time off, no, 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 I don't believe the time.
Well, I just made it to the top of the Shopify hill, and there's nothing here. Well, that's pretty much the best metaphor I can give you for some of these other business models out here today. You see, my name is Iman Gadzhi, and I run one of the fastest growing online education companies in the world. And we teach people to go from ground zero to six figures and beyond with their marketing agency. And one of the biggest issues I see these days with most education companies is they are teaching business models where you climb up this enormous hill, you get to the top, you know, you want to see the fruits of your labor, you want to see, you know, tons of abundance, and there's nothing there because there's nothing left in your bank account at the end of the month. And that is why from zero to seven figures a year profit, right, I'm not talking revenue, I'm talking profit, I like businesses that are cash flowing from day one. I like businesses with low overhead. I like businesses with insane profit margins. Okay, so rather than getting into a business model where it might work, it might not work, you have to invest a ton of money into ads, which, look, to be honest, you know, that's a very hard skill set in itself. Rather than having to invest all this money into ads, into softwares, this, that, instead, why don't you sign a client that pays you $1,500 a month, $2,500 a month? Hell, you know, we've even had students sign $10,000 a month, or what was it, $16,000 a month, I remember. $16,000 a month in the first 21 days of starting their agency, a guy called Brandon. So
this is how you know when you have a dedicated team. We're out here in beautiful Iceland, and Danny is, what do you name? Setting up some ads for one of our clients.
Magic of
the magic Wi-Fi. Of portable Wi-Fi.
So we just got to be honest, I actually have no idea what this place is called, but this is a geothermal spring I was at last time. Let me try and flip that around. Yeah, this is a geothermal spring. I literally went to like 2-3 times last time with Josh. It's just incredible. Geothermal spa, freezing cold lake, steam room, sauna. Honestly, like after this, like after like 2-3 rounds of this, you will never feel presence like it. It's incredible.
I will squeeze maximum efficiency out of my team. I'm making a vlog on what I've learned at building a small team, but you know, this team right here between the three of us, we produce more profit a year than most companies with 30-40 employees.
And so you get
to pour in one, right?
Oh yeah, no, 100%. We'll just go in and ask what's not working.
No, let me get my wallet. Which for you is legendary, right?
For me, that's fantastic. It's two things, and you're to blame for one of them. One, it was too hot. Two, I had a nightmare about you.
What?
That you called me in for a review, and you'd hired a private detective to watch me work, and you were like, I'm actually disappointed because I know you took 3 breaks yesterday to play video games. But you weren't like angry. You were like, we're going to have to fix this. And like, I remember like looking outside my house and like seeing a van. So yeah, that's what's going on in my head now.
That sounds pretty much like reality.
No. Like it's just like some things to come.
I mean, if I have a health coach that has a look at all your stats, and I know exactly when you went to bed and when you went to sleep.
Yeah.
And what quality of sleep you got. So I know every night when you drink alcohol, really.
Iman.
Yeah.
What is that thing?
Dark chocolate, 80% dark chocolate.
Oh yeah, and what is the other thing?
I don't know. That's Kieran. It's Kieran's.
Oh,
wallet.
That's Kieran. Where are we going?
We're going to the abandoned plane wreck thing, and then the abandoned plane wreck thing. And that's on the black sand or the black beach or whatever it's called. Apparently, some of Game of Thrones was filmed there.
Really?
Yeah. Hmm. And then we're going to a waterfall, one of Iceland's many.
And then to a canyon.
And then to a canyon, yeah.
Do you have to swim in the waterfall?
Nah.
Why?
Nah.
Yeah.
Why don't you swim in the waterfall?
Because I'd rather go to like the geothermal spring where we can do the whole rounds and stuff.
Yep.
Is my counter hole shout at me? And amazing news that it came in earlier. You said that it's coming in a week, so that should be like the 9th of October. Question is, can you guys hold it in stock for like 8 days? Obviously at this point I've picked up 12, I've bought like 12 watches, and every single watch, you know, it's been nice, but it doesn't have a real meaning to it, obviously because of the launch of this new big project and stuff like that. On the 17th and the launch party on the 17th, then it'd be nice to pick it up on the morning of and then wear it at the event. And as I said, this will be like the first, not the first watch, but you know, pretty much from the last 10 watches, the only watch that I've picked up with like a real date or meaning to it. If not, then I can always just pick it up next week and then just put it in my vault, or keep it at Harrods until the week after and just like physically pay for it next week. So that's that. In regards to the other thing, I'll send you a voice note now.
You will check the validity of those contractors. So I'll throw you and Danny into WhatsApp group together. He'll check those case studies and let you know whether you should move forward and bring that media buyer on board. And then in terms of getting him lunch, Danny, what lunch do you want?
What lunch?
My friend Jamie's gonna buy you lunch.
Oh, I don't know. He has to surprise me.
Okay, he also wants 10 minutes in the private room at Harrods, at Rolex, to try on some watches and geek out about watches, and then you can take him to Senior Sassy or Mr. Chow and stuff like that. I mean, to be honest, while you, at Senior Sassy and Mr. Chow, obviously ask him any questions you have in terms of workflow and stuff like that. Yeah, I'll throw you guys into a WhatsApp group together now.
It's really weird. My calf hurts.
Your calf?
Yeah. I think I like money.
Why do we know?
I don't know. I really don't.
What about a folding?
Yeah, let's...
If I fall.
Your phone's water...
Alright, well... Ruined my shoes. Come on, Danny.
10 years of basketball for this. If I sleep, I die. No,
this is your moment, Danny.
I'm too scared now.
Danny.
Come on. 3.
2. 1.
Wait.
Hope you lost
it. Come on. 3. 2.
No. Wait, no.
3. 2. 1.
Buckle in. Is this gonna wreck the tires?
Like,
I don't know, does it wreck the tires?
It will take a bit of wear off them.
Okay,
all
right, go for it.
Oh, the car's leaning on its side!
Oh, God! I can't tell, is it drifting?
Oh, no, Mira!
Two wheels.
Oh, Iman, what's that yellow paper?
That is a fine for 37,500 krona, which is roughly around 250 pounds, which unfortunately is Kieran's speeding ticket.
I was being a bit silly.
Kieran was being a bit silly because, you know, we haven't been silly at all on this trip. That was the first time that we sped, and it's very unfortunate that he got caught on camera the first time that we were speeding. 185. And yeah, at least he got on his Amex, so at least he got some points for it.
That's a lot of beer.
Really?
So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed that video. I am actually sat right now in a place called Uncommon. We've got the Meridian Mastermind going on in the meeting room around the corner. Funny enough, this is actually the spot that I was looking at for the company offices, and then decided just not to go the office route at all, which Kieran is not very happy about, because this place is perfect. It's like 5 minutes from my house. It's got parking outside. The actual offices themselves are high quality. I'm a fan, and then they just got a very cool, like, they have like an in-house like barista, all that stuff. It's basically like, it's like a cool WeWork, except you can actually get work done here because it's a private office, not like, yeah, I don't, anyone that works from a WeWork, any company that works from a WeWork is just doesn't actually do any real work, in my opinion. But anyways, hope you enjoyed this video. Yeah, I think it's been a while since I've done a actual proper vlog documentation of a trip. So that's it, hope you enjoyed it. From Kieran and I, Danny's presenting in the other room his part. He's just showing off a $1.5 million case study from 6 months back with one of our e-commerce clients. So he's presenting that now. I'm just wrapping up this edit. Kieran is doing whatever Kieran's doing, one of 100 things he has to do at any given time. Poor guy. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.